CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 1.
Hello children, welcome to today's class. I, Bharati, will be your teacher for this class on chapter 1, Shapes and Spaces. Let's see what we are going to learn in this chapter today. Chapter 1, Shapes and Spaces. Hello children, let's begin this class with a story. A story about a man and his camel. The name of the man was Arab and it was a cold winter day in the story. The Arab was traveling on the camel back. At night, the Arab pitched his tent and went inside it. The camel was outside. Children, you know, camel is a big animal with long legs and a hump on his back. Camel has padded feet which help him walk fast on the sand. Children, many of you might be aware that there is a lot of sand in the desert. And in desert, days are very hot and nights are very cold. A tent is a temporary house made of thick cloth and it can be taken from one place to another. And now, back to our story of Arab and his camel. As you know, it was night, so Arab made his tent and went inside the tent to save himself from cold. The camel was left outside in the cold. After some time, the camel, while sitting outside the tent, made a request to his master. "May I put my neck inside? It is too cold outside." The master was a good man, so he said, "Okay, you may put your neck inside." Now, the Arab and the neck of the camel was inside the tent. After some moments, the camel again asked, Master, may I put my front legs inside? It is too cold outside." The kind master replied, "Okay, you may put your front legs inside." Some more time was spent like this and the camel again requested, Master, can I come inside? It is too cold outside." And this time, the master got angry and said, "Oh no, camel, the tent is too small for both of us." Children, do you know, this camel was very naughty and he was feeling cold. So he said, "I am coming inside, you go outside." And inside he went, pushing the Arab outside in the cold. Children, hope you enjoyed listening to this story. Now, it's question time. Let me ask you some questions based on the story. Question number 1. Where was the camel in the beginning of the night? Inside the tent or outside the tent? Yes, camel was outside the tent. Question number 2. Where was the Arab in the beginning of the night? Inside the tent or outside the tent? Yes, Arab was inside the tent. Question number 3. Where was the camel in the end of the story? Inside the tent or outside the tent? Yes, children. At the end of the story, the camel was inside the tent. Very good. Question number 4. Where was the Arab in the end of the story? Inside the tent or outside the tent? Yes, children. At the end of the story, the Arab was outside the tent. Remember, the camel has pushed him out. Okay, now the last question and the question number 5. In the end of the story, who was inside the tent? The Arab or the camel? Yes, you all know it very well. In the end of the story, the camel was inside the tent, the naughty camel. Yes, very good children. With the help of this story, we learnt the meaning of inside and outside. Let's see how well we have understood inside and outside. So, now who will tell me where you play cricket? Inside your house or outside house? Very easy to answer, isn't it? Yes, we all know that cricket is played outside the house. Okay, tell me where your mother keeps money. Inside purse or outside purse? Yes, children, you must have seen your mother keeping money inside the purse. But sometimes small coins or change, leftover money might be kept outside. When in school, where do you keep your notebooks and books? Inside your school bag or outside your school bag? Good children. You keep your books and notebooks inside your school bag. Let me see now. Who is going to answer this question? Where do we plant trees? Inside our house or outside our house? Now you must be thinking, do I have some pot inside my house? Yes, you may have. But you know, I'm talking about trees. I'm not talking about plants. And trees are quite big. So big trees are always outside our houses. What all things are inside your school bag? Think, what all naughty things you are keeping inside your school bag? Usually, your school bag has your notebooks, your textbooks, your geometry box or pouch, maybe your lunch box, and what? You may like to sneak comic books inside your bag to the school, or maybe some play material also. Now coming back to a very easy question. Can anybody tell me what is inside our mouth? When I'm saying our mouth, you can think what is inside your mouth. Yes, teeth is there. Then your tongue. Okay. Now, your favorite thing. Who will tell me whether the ice cream melts inside the fridge or outside the fridge? Yes, you're very quick in answering this question. The ice cream melts outside the fridge. So children, I hope you have all understood inside and outside. It was very easy, isn't it? Do you want to learn something difficult? I know you are all excited to learn. So children, now let's learn about bigger and smaller. When you go to a park, you come across many leaves and flowers. You also walk on the grass. Have you noticed that some of the leaves and flowers can easily fit into your palm, whereas some don't? Let's call those leaves which fit into your palm the small leaves, and the leaves which doesn't fit into your palm the big leaves. Can you tell me the name of few objects that fit into your palm? You might be thinking about an eraser. You might be calling it a rubber. It is used to rub off the pencil marks from the paper. And usually a rubber fits in easily in the palm of little children like you. Then there is a sharpener. You used to sharpen your pencil, and usually a sharpener also fits in the palm of little children. Yes, toffees also. Toffees can also easily fit in the palm of little children. Have you seen your sports teacher using a whistle? A whistle is also a small object that can easily fit in your palm. And now an edible thing. An almond. An almond, we call it badam in Hindi. It has one pointed end and the other end is rounded. It is very tasty to eat and healthy also. And I'm sure more than two pieces of badam or almond can easily fit in your palm. Yes, there are some biscuits also. And biscuits can come in all the sizes and variety. But there are some biscuits that can easily fit into your palm. Children, there are many things around us. Some are big and some are small. When we compare two things, we may find that both are not equal in size. Say for example, when you compare your palm with the palm of your elder brother or sister, you may find that their palm is bigger than you. Similarly, my cup might be bigger than yours. Your sharpener might be smaller than the one your friend has. So, many times in our lives, we compare two objects and often call them big or small. In your mathematics book, Math Magic, few pair of objects is given. And you have to tell me which one is bigger and which one is smaller. But before that, let's become familiar with these objects and understand what these objects and things are that are mentioned in your mathematics textbook. Object 1. Hippopotamus. Hippopotamus is an animal which is much bigger than you and heavier than you. And hippopotamus lives mostly near water in jungles. Object 2 is dog. You might be familiar with the dog. Dog is an animal that barks and can be found near our houses. A dog may have the smaller or the same size as you are. Third is squirrel. Squirrel is an animal that squeaks, and if you are able to catch one, it can easily fit into your palms. Squirrels are very quick and they mostly live on the trees. Fourth one is cow. Cow is an animal that is surely bigger in size than you and is mostly kept as pet for milk. Object 5. Banana leaf. Banana leaf won't fit your hand. It may be used as plate for eating food, making roof, clothes, etc. Sixth is neem leaf. A neem leaf can easily fit in your palm. Neem leaves are useful for medicinal purposes. And they have a bitter taste. Now children, let's solve the questions given on page 3, Math Magic textbook for class 1. Question 1 is, which one is bigger, a hippopotamus or a dog? Recall the description that I've just given you. Yes, children. A hippopotamus is bigger than a dog. Question number 2. Two pairs are given in this question, and you have to tell me which one is smaller in each pair. The first pair, banana leaf or a neem leaf. Now tell me which leaf is smaller. Yes, Very good. So you are able to recall, neem leaf is smaller, because you remember I told you neem leaf can easily fit into your palm, whereas banana leaf won't be. Second pair in this question is a squirrel or a cow. Yes, children. Recall from the description that I gave you, a squirrel is a small animal. Yes, it lives on the tree. And cow is a bigger animal which is kept as pet for its milk. Now let's move on to question number 3. Question number 3 shows a picture having two tires. And you have to tell which tire is smaller. First tire is from a children's cycle. And second tire is a tire from an adult cycle. Think about it. You may take help from your mother or father or elder brother or sister. So, find the answer. Which tire is smaller? For this question, no, I'm not going to give you the answer. Just think and verify the answer from your parents or brother or sister. Children, it was very easy, wasn't it? Now, let me ask you a tricky question. How will you decide which one is bigger or which one is smaller when instead of two, three objects are given? Say for example, I give you a banana leaf, a neem leaf and also a tamarind leaf. Now, there are three objects. The tamarind leaf and the neem leaf can easily fit in your palm. So, you may like to call them small leaves. We already know that banana leaf is a big leaf as it can't fit into our palm. So now we have to decide between the neem leaf and the tamarind leaf. You can compare the size of the neem leaf and the tamarind leaf by touching them or by keeping one leaf over the other. After comparing the size, you will find that a tamarind leaf is smaller than the neem leaf. So now we know that a tamarind leaf is smaller than a neem leaf is smaller than the banana leaf. So in this three given objects, the tamarind leaf is smaller than the other two objects. So it is called the smallest. The banana leaf is bigger than the other two objects, so it is called the biggest leaf. So children, if three objects are given and someone asks which one is biggest and which one is smallest, you can do it just like we did for these three leaves. Now let's try solving similar question from page 4, Mathemagic textbook. Class 1 and try to find the smallest and the biggest from the given three objects. Let's begin with question number 1. In question number 1, picture of three trees are given and you have to tell which one is smallest. Tricky one? Let's follow the procedure that we have adopted for the leaves. You can do this question by comparing first the tree 1 and then the tree 2. If I am comparing tree 1 and tree 2, I am having a pair. And how to find the big and small from the pair? You know it easily. If you have problem in seeing the pictures, you can ask your parent or your brother or sister to mark a bindi on the top and bottom of all the three trees. This will become your tactile mark for top and bottom of the tree. After this, you can measure the height of each tree using a scale or a thread. This can be done for all the four questions on this page. Why I am saying all the four questions on this page? Because all the four questions contains pictures that needs to be measured or compared with each other. Now coming back to the question number one. Out of the tree 1 and tree 2, children, if we measure, we find that tree 1 is smaller. Similarly, let's compare the tree 1 and tree 3. Aha, we find that tree 1 is the smallest. So, our answer to this question is, tree 1 is the smallest tree of the three trees given. Question number 2. In this question, picture of three animals is given. And you have to tell which one is biggest, the dog or the cat or the elephant. Yes, children, follow the same procedure and find which one is bigger from the first two animals. And the answer that you have obtained from this pair, you can use that to compare the third animal. So the first two animals are dog and the cat, and you have to find which one is bigger. So which one would be bigger from the cat and the dog? Yes, the dog would be bigger. Now compare dog with the elephant. And you know, children, elephant is an animal that has a trunk and is quite bigger in size than you. So if the elephant is bigger in size than you, then what's your guess about who is bigger between dog and elephant? Yes, children, elephant is the biggest out of the three animals that are given. So elephant is bigger than dog. Elephant is also bigger than the cat. So in this question, the correct answer would be elephant is the biggest animal. Let's move on to the question number 3. In this question, picture of three fruits is given. Fruit 1 is mango, fruit 2 is cherry, and fruit 3 is watermelon. And you have to tell which fruit is the smallest. So again, compare the first two fruits, mango and cherry. Yes, cherry is small out of mango and cherry. Now compare cherry with watermelon. You know, watermelon, that fruit which has green outer layer, and when you cut it, it's red from inside, and it is certainly bigger than the cherry. So the correct answer for this question is cherry is the smallest fruit out of the three fruits given in this question. So children, today we have learnt about inside, outside, bigger, smaller, biggest and smallest. Now, homework time for you. Don't worry, you don't have to write anything for completing this homework. This homework you can do on your own, or if you want, you can take help of your friend, brother, sister, father or mother. So what you have to do is the three questions. And these are your three questions. Question number 1. Please identify 5 things inside house and 5 things which are outside your house. Easy? And you don't have to write anything. Second is, find the biggest utensil in the kitchen. For this question, you have to take the help of your parents. And question number 3, find the smallest tomato or potato from the vegetables available in your house. Now you must be thinking, okay, I've done the homework, but who is going to check this homework? This homework can be checked with the help of your parents or elder brother or sister. So children, till the next time, stay happy and stay safe, and do wash your hands regularly with soap and water.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Lang Lingdo. Produced by Ajit Horo. This series was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.